that as well. But he comes from Santa Ana, California, is a vicious, mean man when he fights, and probably the nicest guys I've ever met. Like, literally, most fighters don't get along with me. I just stylistically, personally, we don't get along. Gilbert and I get along famously. It's amazing how well we get along because he's such a nice guy. But once he gets inside those ropes, it's over. He literally, I don't know what the switch is. I don't know if it's a chemical imbalance. I don't know if they keep him off his ADD medication. I don't know what it is. He literally turns crazy and fights with that viciousness the entire time. Mitsuhiro Ishida, 14-3-1. Obviously, the crowd, the fans love Ishida. Tremendously famous. Has the exact same style as Melendez. Straightforward, constant pressure. You're literally going to see the most high action fight of the night for me. This is my fight of the night because of the action that's going to happen.
As we take a look at the tail of the tape, no one has defeated Gilbert Melendez. Ishida coming in here. Three of his victories by way of knockout. Had a 9-fight win streak stopped by, and we'll mention this name again, just a year ago, Domi defeated him with a TKO. So Ishida has been in against some of the best. Melendez certainly has picked it up and has really had a meteoric rise since debuting in the WEC back in 2002. Much anticipation about this matchup.
Just off camera, Kenny, I can see it's because they're in our corner. Kawajiri is actually in Ishida's corner, so he just won tonight. And immediately came out to support his training partner, his teammate.
Gilbert Melendez, he started off his career. He won his first 5 fights by way of technical knockout. The last 4 victories come by way of decision for the 25-year-old Californian. And round 1 begins.
Obviously, Gilbert has a long range, a long reach. A little bit bigger, a little bit taller.
And here's a guy that will take advantage of that reach that he has.
Gilbert doesn't mind at all staying on his feet. He's got great uppercuts, which feed right into Ishida's style because Ishida likes to shoot. Gilbert's going to catch him with an uppercut as he tries to get in.
Melendez pawing out there with that jab as Ishida tries for the single leg. And Melendez hanging tough, but not now.
Ishida trying to power his way into this.
And Melendez standing up. Ishida showing some good power here early on. Get this right back on the ground.
And the top side crucifix is his opposite side from the camera, as his arm caught. Trying to this reverse power half on this side. He's got to be a little bit careful here. Ishida needs to keep pushing that head down.
Right now, Melendez, no place to put that right arm. You see Ishida working on the left.
Good job changing position.
Now Melendez back and free. Tries to cut the rope down. Tries to cut the ring down and hit the rope more than the opponent there, but the crowd loves it.
She's got a lot of movement, a lot to his left. He's moving right into Gilbert's right hand, though. Should be moving the other way to get away from that power right.
Melendez corner there telling him to double the jab wheel over here.
because he has just been flicking it out there, almost pawing instead of punching. Okay, as quick as Ishida, you want to make sure snapping punches of those can get in again. There's Ishida again grabbing hold and going down. Great takedown game on Ishida. A lot, really much improved from the last time I saw him fight. Ishida only a couple of submission victories. He's had 11 of his wins have come by way of decision. He certainly doesn't mind going the distance and racking up the points. Trying to keep him in the ring. You know, there's probably six extra officials on the outside of the ring to keep everyone inside for better safety.
And for those who may be unfamiliar, those were officials that were not some random fan sitting courtside like in the Lakers game, pushing the ball back in.
Yeah, it wasn't Jack Nicholson trying to push it back in. Ishida really hasn't thrown any punches as of yet. Melendez has been really banging up, controlling the feet, but getting taken down every time.
Ishida now with three takedowns here in this first round. Going for the back now, Melendez. In a bear hug, he's hanging on. Well, Melendez trying to slam it from this position.
Ishida gets his head in front. There it is.
Does.
Great job.
He drives him into the canvas. And now Melendez going for the choke. He's going for the guillotine.
He's got the chin cut underneath. You can see his hand cutting that chin if he can extend his body out. He's got the length extended if he hasn't been tight enough. Looks like his hand's coming free, though.
Crowd appreciates the effort by Ishida to get out of that.
Great position change.
Melendez with that slam that echoes throughout this packed arena. Now it's Ishida trying to get back in control of this fight. He's had the most takedowns and picking up the points here in this first round.
Nice side control position. Good job landing on his hips.
Ishida trying to measure Melendez, but he's going to work more on those knees a minute ago, Frank, but he opted not to.
Remember these rules, not to knee an opponent at any time, whether he's on his feet or not. That's a great position. Oh, you see a nice knee by Gilbert, body finally. He's finally using his legs a little bit.
Like the clinch, good striking by Melendez. Keep waiting to see if he will try some combination or double up on that jab as his corner was trying to encourage him.
Now he's starting to reach a little bit with his punching. He's getting a little bit more nervous about the takedown.
Halfway here in this first round. Here on Yarunoka, the biggest fight night of the year in Japan and their biggest day of the year, New Year's Day. Just a little over 2 hours away here in Tokyo and at the Saitama Super Arena. It is a packed house. Fedor's return. And also to see a great undercard that includes Gilbert Melendez, who was just slammed once again to the mat by Mitsuhiro Ishida.
Gilbert did a great job after getting slammed, trying to roll the triangle. Even better job by Ishida to get out of it. As I said earlier, nonstop action. These guys tend to keep going, tend to keep moving.
And Ishida, who's been inactive for almost a year, obviously Melendez hasn't, but Ishida comes out here in full strength. Once again, just as he stands up, Ishida gets another takedown, and Melendez is back up and goes into the corner.
Now, what people are wondering, I'm sure, and I'm speculating. I'm not positive what Gilbert's doing this, but if a guy that keeps taking you down over and over again, you put yourself in the corner, it's harder for him to take you down. There's less positions for him to move you to, as if you're in the center of the ring. Oh, he's got the Kimura.
Melendez trying for his submission attempt. 3 minutes left.
Yoshida back in control, getting the back out. Melendez just under 3 minutes in this first 10-minute round. She has had success with these takedowns. It's really all she has done really is use punching and get inside, and then it's become a submission match from his standpoint. Well, Gilbert the whole entire time is trying to create space and start swinging again. Now you're going to start seeing as this fight goes longer, whose style is to control the other man's style better. That's one of the judges again holding on to the ropes there. 2 minutes and 20 seconds. And again, Yoshida going for that takedown.
Two minutes.
A little over 2 minutes to go here in round number one. Gilbert Melendez with his unbeaten streak on the line. And trying to go 2-0 on New Year's Eve here in Tokyo, won last year. Great wrestling ability by Yoshida, who was stuck in a weird position, kept going back to the takedown. Yoshida making sure he avoids one of those up kicks. As the back of Melendez, who's going to be warned for grabbing onto that rope. Once again, Yoshida going piggyback there for a moment. Melendez spinning out of it, delivers a couple of knees. Almost was able to unload with the combinations.
Yoshida's so quick. The moment the punch is coming, his body is almost faster than his punches, which is unheard of.
A minute to go in this first round.
Okay. 1 minute. 40 seconds.
Got that arm caught. He's used to his advantage if he can. It's a good Kimura position. If he wants to go ahead and lock it in, he can finish it from here because he's got his head caught in there too. A little awkward. Just about a half a minute to go here in this opening 10-minute round. Melendez and Yoshida. And Yoshida gets another takedown after taking some slaps from Melendez. And now he's trying for a guillotine at the bell. That is the end of the first round.
Now, for the Japanese fans, it's a huge fight because T-Blood is Yoshida and Kawajiri. And Melendez beat Kawajiri in a 15-minute decision. And Kawajiri wants to get this fight back. He wants to get it back. And you see this big slam at the beginning by Gilbert right when Yoshida got on his back. But he couldn't take advantage of it. Yoshida did a good job protecting himself and rolling over and coming right back up, getting back to his feet, getting caught in a guillotine, and then defends this as well. There's a great lift job here on Gilbert and repays the favor, but Gilbert tries to roll immediately into a triangle lock, and Yoshida gets himself out of that. Both these guys, even though getting lifted and slammed, but looking to move and looking to maneuver, this is a big fight for Yoshida because he can revenge the loss that Kawajiri had, his business partner and his training partner, to Gilbert if he wins this fight.
And Yoshida was on that same fight card a year ago. As a matter of fact, this is the fourth time that they've been on the same card. The first time that they have met in the ring, but Yoshida and Melendez, they know each other well. They've seen each other fight. They've shown up in the same locker room three other occasions over here to see big fights.
And they definitely know each other's style and ability. They've seen each other compete quite a bit together. Plus, there's a lot of tape in each guy. It's this fight is really whose style is just a little bit better today, because it's basically mirror images of each other. If you remove the height factor, you know, Yoshida, of course, is a little bit slower, but you're seeing how quick, as you take a look here at Jay-Z, who was supposed to fight Aoki later tonight, got hurt and is unable to compete because of his injury.
And we get ready for the second round, 5 minutes. It's scheduled for, and here they go. We'll see if Melendez is able maybe to pick up his punching a little bit more, too. Ishida right on him.
He knows now that he lost that first 10 minutes. He's got to make it all up now in the last 5 minutes. It's a difficult against a guy like Ishida, who's so quick, lowers his level so fast.
Ishida is probably as fast as anybody Melendez has faced. You think?
This is the fastest I've seen him because no one else is really this aggressive. And I got to be honest with you, Ishida's one of the fastest guys I've seen.
Yeah, he's incredibly quick.
At least getting the shot. Not necessarily on his hands, but the punching power, but definitely getting the shot.
He's kept Melendez off balance. Good knee by Melendez. His best strike so far. Ishida piggyback here with Melendez. Slam him again. Not as hard that time. Ishida was holding on tight. He needs to get a little more space. He's got to get up. He wants to win this fight. Ishida just needs to keep doing what he's doing. Gilbert Melendez has never lost. He's rapidly been moving up the lightweight ranks. That streak in jeopardy now here in the second round. So they will be moving back out now to the middle of the ring. What about the ground game here of Melendez against the ultra-quick Ishida?
It's a good position, but she's doing a great job of holding him down. We don't really see the ground and pound game against Ishida. Look like.
Ishida's fought a very determined fight. Controlled the tempo much of the way.
Constant head motion, hit motion by both fighters. With a lot of position changes. Ishida now is in the control.
Ishida going for the arm. Holding on tight to that left arm. Melendez trying to avoid the submission and does. Melendez trying to hold on to his unbeaten record.
He's in jeopardy here, I gotta be honest with you. So far, he's completely dominated, but definitely winning this fight at this point with about a minute and a half left.
It's a Hiro Ishida. Getting those takedowns early in that fight, dictating the tempo of the first round. Gilbert Melendez has not been able to, seems to get on his game, especially in his punching. We heard his corner say, double up on those jabs, and he was never able to get in that kind of stand-up.
Both fighters have been in this tight situation before. It's difficult, you know, find what kind of fighter you are when all of a sudden your unbeaten record is coming up on being, you know, finally getting that first loss. What's going to happen to him when it's close and tight?
A minute to go in this fight. Melendez trying to get that arm free, his right arm.
She just desperately holding on to that. Holding on to that, not letting it go.
Ishida probably sensing, if I could just hold on here, I think I've already done enough to win this fight. I can keep Melendez from getting that one big blow or getting into a rhythm of a ground and pound here to close out. Melendez with Legacy here in the final seconds of this fight. A flurry by Melendez, but will it be enough to keep him unbeaten against Mitsuhiro Ishida?
Aggressiveness is about the same. You gotta go down takedowns. Obviously, Ishida wins the takedown game. You know, submissions. I think Gil had a little bit more time to put submissions on because he was on the bottom a little bit more. But, you know, as you see him finally lowering his level. Great knee right into the chin, but then got sucked back in again and was unable to, you know, follow up with more strikes. And then from the bottom position, you can see Ishida working. This is the tightest submission of the game, even though Gil had more submission attempts. This is the tightest one, and Gilbert did a great job of getting out of this thing. Most other fighters would have tapped on that. And it passes through, and you can see, you know, different angle, the same thing as he's trying to work his way out of it. It's the front side of it. You know, that arm is fully extended, but Gilbert just shows how tough he is and finally turns his wrist out.
You can see the determination on his face, and then here it is. It's about the last 15 seconds of the fight when he is able to unleash some punches.
He really wanted to get moving, really try to get after it.
Was it enough? The judges have made their decision. Ishida on his way to a unanimous decision. Mitsuhiro Ishida has handed Gilbert Melendez his first career loss.
It's all right, Gilbert shouldn't hang his head down at all. It was obviously, just got beat tonight by a better guy in the takedown game. He's going back and fix him. He went hard, he went, you know, and obviously went as quick as he could and tried to do as much as he could. You have to give it to Ishida. He fought a great fight.
Mitsuhiro Ishida, last fought, New Year's Eve 2006, here 2007 in Tokyo. He comes back strong, knocking off previously unbeaten Gilbert.